Episode 2078, Stepping Up is Hard.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. Guess what? Take a deep breath. It is time for a celebration because it's Friday. Yay. Yes, it is. You made it through the week. And I know things are a little crazy. Guess what? It's Confessions of an Upset Mama. That means you get to let everything hang out, just real and raw. Let your heart ache a little bit if you have to, because stepping up is hard. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, as we grow in age, life requires us to respond to experiences and gain wisdom. With this comes challenges. Stepping up is hard. It's really hard. You know, this virtual schooling thing is a little wacky, and that's the nicest way to address the chaos it has put us all in, right? I mean, come on, can I get an amen? I'm just saying. Now, if you're in an area that is operating normally, be grateful. Exclamation point, be grateful. Another exclamation point. Don't take it for granted. Routine does the mind and body good. And oh my goodness, this too shall pass. Yes, I know. Those of you who are wrapped up in it, I'm there with you. This too shall pass. It's another day. It's another moment. It's another event that says, you know what? We made it. We learned from it. Now let's move on. So I was just really thinking about how our children are having to deal with all this stuff that we never did growing up. The worst thing I can remember was chicken pox in school. Yeah, do you remember the breakouts that you would have? Like one kid would get it in the class, and then the next thing you know, there's like three of them, and all of a sudden you've got like half the school, and you're like, ah! And that's even sometimes if they had the vaccination. Now, that was many years. Now, when I was growing up, we didn't have a vaccination, right? You got the chicken pox. I got the chicken pox. I got them twice. Shh, don't tell anybody. But yeah, I did. And then the other thing that I think about is snow. We would close down for like 2 weeks because we literally had 2 feet worth of snow. We couldn't get out. No one could. I mean, the area shut down. And that was great because you got to hang out. You would go. It was back in the good old days, right? You remember those good old days. But otherwise, life was pretty simple. Well, our children are being expected to step up even at a young age. And some of these challenges are good for them. Children are resilient. However, there is still a lot of growing up that needs to happen. And unfortunately, I know there are some parents that parent the way, oh, I got to protect them. I'm going to keep them in a bubble and they will be fine. And when they need to, they'll be prepared and they can handle anything. And then you have those parents on the other spectrum that's like, nope, I'm not doing anything for my child. Good luck. That's how I was raised. You're doing it too. And then you've got the middle, right? And everything in between. I don't know where you fall, but what I do know is that children have to grow up. And we have to begin to allow them to step up. Because stepping up is hard. It's not easy, especially as a kid. I mean, think about it. Do you like going and talking to your boss? Probably not. Because you got to put your big girl panties on or your big boy briefs. And then you go and you're like, this is what I want and this is what I'm demanding. And if you don't like it, I'm walking out. It's great when they respond positively, but when they respond negatively, then what do? You're like, oh, I didn't think that through. What do you do if your child is placed in a situation where he needs to step up, where she needs to show that she's got confidence and she can learn as she grows? Well, strategy is the name of the game. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Strategy. Yes, strategy. Our key word here is the name of the game. We can give our children so much. And I know with me and my husband, that's what we've always wanted to do. Neither of us grew up with a lot. We never went without food. However, It wasn't like we had everything that we wanted all the time. There were those friends, and I'm sure you had those, that they had absolutely everything. And then you had some that you're like, gosh, I don't know where he's eating, but somehow he's managing. We give our children so much, and I get that that's what we want to do. And answers are one of them. We want to give and give and give, but sometimes the greatest gift we can give is space for growth. And that's so challenging, more so for us rather than for them. Because we're the ones like, I just want to tell them the answer. Well, if you tell them the answer, they're not going to figure it out on their own again. They're going to forget because they didn't have to think it through. Having the space to create strategy gives them a way to gain wisdom. It's through critical thinking. And yes, I'm all for critical thinking. We need to have more of it. But unfortunately, we're into the quick answers. We live our life right through the drive-thrus. And so that's how we're doing with our parenting. We're living through the drive-thrus. Now, I know you might be a little uncomfortable, and that's okay, because I want to push the envelope a little bit today. I want to push the boundaries. I want you to think about things beyond your comfort zone, because I know I have to do that. And that helps me what? To grow as a parent, as a mom, as a human being, as a wife. You name it, it helps me. And so we need to be able to allow our kids the space to think their thoughts, not ours. So what does that look like when we say strategy is the name of the game? Well, number one, you got to scrub for gold. Now, I know you're thinking, what? This is crazy. Well, so much of what is needed is right in front of us. I think about walking on the beach, and you would just walk, and you know the easiest things to grab are those shells that are right there on top, or maybe there's some money that was dropped and you find it and you can pick it up. It's right there. But the problem is there's so many things around it. There's noise, there's distractions. Sometimes you don't always see what's right in front of you. We can get hung up in life. We think, oh, I got to have this particular seashell. It's got to look exactly like this. I want it to be pink in this area with a little brown here and maybe a little few specks of black. And that's what I'm searching for. And all we do is we go and search for that. And what happens is it leads us down the wrong area. If we would have just taken two steps up, we would have seen the exact shell that we were looking for. Scrub for gold. What can I do right now? What do I understand now? Where are the weaker areas? It's what you see on the surface level. It's the tangible things, the quick grab. Our kids, believe it or not, they're brilliant and they have a lot of quick grab if we would be quiet and let them think for themselves. Yes, you heard me right. We need to let our kids think a little bit. Now, that doesn't mean you don't have influence. Please understand, you have a lot of influence. But we also have to grow our kids up, because stepping up is hard and they got to do it. So the first step is scrub for gold. Number two, build curiosity. You know that curiosity killed the cat, but it can teach a child. I just love that. Curiosity killed the cat, but it can teach a child. Encourage your child to think beyond what is known. They got to ask the questions. They've got to search deeper. They've got to find things out so they understand them. And I got to tell you right now, I have five children and every one of their brains work differently. It's amazing. Now, are all of them brilliant? You better believe it. This mama's going to say they are all brilliant. Some of them are gifted in other areas more than some, and that's fine. That's what makes them unique. And I love seeing that. It's just my pot of gold. Literally, I have five beautiful little gold coins and they're adorable, but they all operate differently. You want to encourage your child to think beyond what they know. Have them ask questions. Have them dig deeper when it comes to, gosh, what are my thoughts and feelings on this? Where would this take me? Now, obviously, if you're working with a two-year-old, your thoughts and how you build curiosity is going to be different than working with a 12-year-old or a 20-year-old. But you still need to work with them. They all need to have that curiosity built in. They don't need, oh, here you go, fast food answer right in your lap. No, scrub for gold, build curiosity. And finally, number three, let them fly. This is where they take what is learned and apply it to an action. Take aim. You got to let them fly. As much as we think we are protecting them and we think that's helping them, isn't always the right answer. And I know you don't want to hear that, but I have had to watch my children from carrying them in my little tummy. Okay, it wasn't always little, but carrying them in my tummy all the way now to watching them, our oldest daughter, now having her own baby. I can't tell her everything. I can be there to support her. I can be there to show her or to tell her my experiences. But she needs to focus on hers. And so I need to be able to say, this is what I know. Now, guess what? You got to fly, girl. You got this. You can go figure it out. You can take action. If you have a problem, these are the questions you need to ask. Have you thought about this? It's a conversation. It's not about, oh, wait, you know, this is Parenting 101. Turn to chapter 20, and here are all the answers for how to tell your daughter what to expect when she's pregnant. Yeah, that's not going to work. It doesn't work when your son comes home and says, I'm going to buy a new car, and the car is going to cost him like a lot of insurance money because it's a really fast car, and he wants to color it something that's really fast, and you're like, this is not a good decision. But he's working. He's paying for it, not only the vehicle, but also the insurance. So who am I to say? No. It's about strategy is the name of the game. It's about saying, okay, this is where you are. Look at all of this, building curiosity and then letting them go and make those decisions. And you know what? Are they going to fall once in a while? Oh, yes, they will. But your love will pick them back up again because you have unconditional love. So it's not whether or not they go and succeed. You love them because of who they are to you. They're your child. You can't ever get rid of them. I'm sorry. It doesn't work that way. And if you ever have, I don't know that I really want to know that secret. I'm just saying. But it's so important for us to grow our children. This is just a really fun time right now because with our home, we have two in college. We have one in high school. And then we have me. And when we're all in the same room and we're sitting there and we're having conversation, but we're all working on different projects, it's amazing what happens. And so my son says, Mom, you know, I've been thinking about something. And I'm like, okay. We were given bonus points if we won. He goes, but I was on the losing team. And so we didn't get those bonus points. And he says, I really don't think that's fair. Now, you can imagine what's going on in my mind, right? Okay, you're right. That's not fair. Because my son lost. It's not fair. But then I thought, okay, wait a minute. But this is his problem and his area. I want him to think a little bit more. And so he started to work this out. He was like, well, you know, it doesn't make sense. I understand why she did it. She wanted involvement. She wanted kids to participate. And so she gave an incentive. I'm like, yes, you're right. He was scrubbing for gold. He was like, this is why she wanted it this way. So right, you're spot on. He goes, but when I look at it further, we were working just as hard as the other team who won. So it's really not fair that they got the points and we didn't. We didn't even get like half the amount of points as bonus points to add to a test. That's just not fair. And I said, okay, if it's not fair, then how can you make it fair? Building curiosity. So he begins to think it through and talk through the whole thing and he's got more ideas and he's like, okay, Mom, I've got this. And so he's sharing them with me. We're going back and forth. Now, this is over a period of about 45 minutes. And we had even been talking about it just briefly when I picked him up after school. He's on the hybrid schedule. And so that was the day that he was actually at school. So I picked him up and he told me what was going on. He goes, but I don't know what that looks like because I don't know what I got on the test and I won't have the bonus points. So we'll just see what happens. But then he started thinking about it more, even before he knew his score on the test. And he said, I don't get this. So building curiosity, he wanted to dive deeper. And he couldn't figure out why. He's like, okay, well, if she wants to get bonus points, great. I get that she wants student involvement, but how can she create an atmosphere to where it does all of those things, but it's fair for everybody? He goes, how can we work this out? And I was like, that's a good question. So he started talking more and more and more. Well, actually what happened is that he realized, you know what, Mom, it really doesn't have anything to do with bonus points. I was like, it doesn't? He goes, no. He goes, because of the way we're set up, we don't have enough instruction time. And he goes, I'm one who needs to study and I need to study more and then I need to study some more. And he goes, there's some things I just don't get. And so I rely on those bonus points because I feel like I'm, you know, bringing up the rear. And he said, I just really need some time for assistance, for more instruction. And I said, really? He goes, yeah, so it's really not about the bonus points. And I said, okay. Well, his teacher responded and she said, I'd be happy to meet with you. And so they're following up with this meeting that they're going to have together. No, the meeting hasn't happened yet, but it's going to happen. And he's just laying out in his head, okay, this is what it is. And so he responded to his teacher and said, great, we can meet either tonight or tomorrow. And he pressed send. It went out, let him fly. It's hard to let our children spread their wings and fly, but it's the most important thing you can do. Do I want my child to do the best and to have the best? Of course, and so do you. But they also have to be able to find their way. They have to be willing to know that they can find their way. Because I hate to tell you this, but it's confession day, and so I'm just going to let it all hang out. There's going to be a day that you will not be present. And when that day comes, you want to know that you already instilled in them a strategy to scrub for gold, to build curiosity so that they could fly. They can accomplish anything that they want to with just those three little things. But we as parents have to be willing to do that. I know you probably thought stepping up was hard. It is on all sides. When your child grows, so do you. Go out today, be that incredible mom, be that fabulous dad. Love on your kiddos. They grow up so fast. Hold them tight. Because believe it or not, they may not say it much, but they love you too. Be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.